A blessed afternoon to each and everyone. Again, this is Chur April and welcome to Cookery Grade 10, Quarter Number 3, Module Number 5. Can you tell me what have you remembered so far on our previous discussion? Let's take a look. What have you remembered about colors? In plating, you must have at least 3 colors on your plate. You have to remember the word fast, F for flavor, S for shapes, and T for textures, which has a different variations and quality. For today, we're going to talk about how are we going to prepare and present fish and seafood dishes. This will be our learning targets for today. I know how to prepare and present fish and seafood dishes. I can perform guidelines in serving fish and seafood dishes, and I can demonstrate various methods in plating fish and seafood hygienically. Market forms of fishes. We have the whole or round. They are completely intact as caught. We can see this in the market. We also have the drone. The viscera are removed. Viscera means these are the body parts of the fish. We have the dress. The viscera, scales, head, tail, and fins are removed. In short, the fish had been cut into pieces. We also have the steaks, wherein the cross-section slices, each containing a section of backbone. And we have the sticks or trenches, which are cross-section slices of fillets. So, let's take a look on the market forms. Have you remember what we have discussed just a while ago? Then let's continue. These are fillet, which are boneless side of fish with or without skin, and butterflied fillets, both sides of a fish still joined but with bones removed. These are the daing in the Philippines. There are characteristics and market forms of shellfish. We have to remember for crustaceans that has an outer shells and joint legs, the lobster shell is dark green or bluish green but turns red when cooked. Then we also have lobster that should be alive when cooked so that it will be fresh. How about for mollusks? Scallops are creamy white in color and have a sweet flavor. Squid is somewhat chewy and are cut up or either fried quickly. Oysters have rough, irregular shells. Flesh of oyster is extremely soft and delicate and contains high percentage of water. Hard shell clams can be eaten raw. Soft shell clams are called steamers. The usual way to cook is to steam. And the shells of mussels are not as heavy as clam shells, yellow to orange in color, and firm but tender when cooked. In the market forms, we have to take note when it comes with the shellfish, they have shuck, fresh or frozen, or they may be live in the shell. We also have con. I think these are not yet available in the Philippines. And on the other market forms, we can have cooked meat that can be either fresh or frozen, or we can also have the live one. Have you remembered this one? Then can you tell me what are the different market forms of fish? Let's have the first picture. I'll be giving you 3 seconds to answer. That is a whole fish. How about this one? That is a drone fish. This one? What kind of fish is that? That kind of fish is a dress fish. And this one, it is a steak. This one, butterfly. And the last one, we have the sticks. Wow, good job if you have answered everything. We have some cooking techniques for fish and shellfish. Fish is very delicate and easily overcooked. So during the cooking, tests for doneness must be observed most of the time. The fish just separates into flakes, I'm telling you. And if bone is present, the flesh separates from the bone and the bone is no longer pink. The flesh becomes opaque, usually white. This is an example of a lean fish. Lean fish has almost no fat, so it is easily becomes dry. It is best served with sauces to enhance the moistness and gives richness. Poaching is the moist heat method suited, and fish should be basted with butter or oil if broiled or baked. Lean fish may be fried or sauteed to gain palatability from added fat. Lean fish are fish that are high in fats. For the fat fish, or rather, when we talk about the lean fish, they are low in fat because we have the fat fish. Okay, for the fat in fish enables them to tolerate more heat without becoming dry. Fat fish can be cooked by poaching, and fat fish are well suited to broiling and baking. The dry heat methods eliminate excessive oiliness. Large fat fish like salmon and mackerel may be cooked in fat, but care should be taken to avoid excessive greasiness. Shellfish cook oyster just enough to heat thoroughly to keep it juicy and plump. Clams become tough and rubbery if overcooked. Shrimps, like other shellfish, become tough and rubbery when cooked at high temperature. How are we going to open clams? First, we have to scrub clams under cool running water using a stiff kitchen brush. Then, over a bowl, hold the clam firmly in your hand and insert the clam knife between the top shell and bottom shell. A towel can be used to protect your hand, or you can also wear a gloves. Work the knife around to cut through the hinge muscles. The bowl will catch the liquor from the clam. How are we going to open it? Open the shell, slide the knife between the clam and the shell, detach the clam. The clam is now ready to be cooked or eaten raw. That's for the clam. How about for the oyster? So in the oyster, first you have to point out your knife on the tip of your knife on the oyster. Then you have to twist knife handle to pop oyster open. Then you have to push the knife into oyster and slice muscles from top shell. Be careful in handling it. Then you're going to open top shell. This requires a lot of pressure from your hand. That's why this is the last step, is to cut muscle from bottom cup. Turn the meat over for most professional appearance. That's all for today. So hope you learned something from me. Please don't forget to like, share, and hit the notification bell button for more updates. See you again next week. Bye.